afraid of the lock. My soul to take, my soul to take, my soul to take, my soul to take. Hey, get on your job, little man. This ain't Saturday.
Early in my life, which stuck with me, which is that while you're on the journey, you have to disconnect from the end goal. You know, because if you're just focused on some end goal, then you might get there, but it'll be hard to progress past that because you're so focused on that one destination that it's like, you know, you maybe forget everything in between, and maybe you could have done more in between. He always told me, like, just be here right now, live right now, and do the best you can right now. Don't worry about what that end goal
is. Let's go.
Let's go.
What's good, y'all? So, hopping on the vlog, or I grabbed the camera today because we're about to go pick up the restock of the Signature Tee. So if you guys are watching this, they are available again. We'll go pick some stuff up. Link is in the description below, in all sizes. Hope you guys love it. Other than that, I'm about to head to Durham to go pick up the apparel. That's pretty much it. They got that and I got deadlifts today. All right, I'll catch y'all in a little bit. This is our signature tee that will always be in stock. We just have that inner tag, so super clean, super simple. I love these. This is something that I always want to make sure is on the website so that you guys can always get some of this apparel. Very clean, nothing on the back, just a simple badge tee. Low, hope you guys love it. I'm just so thrilled to be able to share my passion with you guys and the fact that you guys support the dream and the vision and what the brand stands for. Just means so much to me. So while I'm here, actually, let me show you guys some of the bags we just got. New poly mailers that we just got. So a simple design, just the badge on the front, nothing on the back. So this will now be what we package and send out our orders.
Moving today. So great way to start off this first week of the block. RP5, I'm feeling good. After that meet, things were kind of iffy. So the fact that we were able to move 485 this block, considering last block we were starting with 455, is huge. That means a big deficit pulls on the way. But enough talking, I gotta head to work. Gotta go cook some food. Catch y'all tomorrow.
Hold up! Whoa, whoa,
whoa, whoa. Pretty limited on time today. We have pause squats and Larson press today. Overall feeling pretty good. It's about 9 a.m. in the morning on Tuesday. So Tuesday, January 12th. If you guys haven't already heard, Raw Nationals is happening in June and your boy is excited. So kind of going to announce right now, early on, is that we are doing that meet and it's about, 23 weeks out. So I don't think I'm actually gonna start prep until 12 weeks out, but just kind of excited to know that Raw Nats is gonna happen this year and that we have a big goal at hand. So we qualified in our last meet in November and gave us a 700 kg total. This time at Nationals, definitely gonna try to, you know, add some pounds to that total and hit some big lifts in competition. So right now our main focus is just staying in the pocket and pushing when we have to, not pushing for clout or any type of ego lifts, you know? So, gonna do some pause squats today. I did 405 last week. I'm thinking about doing like 418 this week. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Gonna go do some warm up, some mobility, and I'll catch y'all on top set of squats. Okay. Just got back from the gym. We hit 419 for a top set of four. Back downs were 352 pounds. Pretty good day. You know, I felt very stacked. Body was not hurting. And just had that mind-muscle connection today. We're really good. Really happy about that. I felt like everything was just consistent throughout each set. And then for the Larsen press, we did 245 pounds for our top set of four. Back downs were 205. Nothing crazy. Just some slight work. And then tonight I'm gonna do my accessory work. Because stop. You still gotta get in your accessories. Accessories are essential. They are so important for your success and growth as a lifter or just in the gym overall. But yeah, I'm actually cooking some 93.7 ground beef, and then gonna have some white rice and some veggies on the side. Keep it simple, keep it plain. You know, you gotta do what you gotta do to reach those goals. Like I said, Raw Nationals is coming in June, so we got plenty of time to get better, to grow, and to hit the goals that we have set for ourselves. I'll see y'all tomorrow. We got deadlifts. My lift is out there. If you ever have any back pain or like any discomfort, I highly recommend, let's see, we're gonna focus, Tiger Bone. This will be your best friend. It's like BioFreeze, but a little bit stronger. I normally put this on for my beltless work or if I'm having like any minor pain or aches, but nothing too crazy. So I don't rely on this, but I do believe that it does give a little bit of an advantage for like beltless work or, you know, those days where your body are fighting you back. So yeah, I'm gonna put this on my back, and we're gonna start these deadlifts. Let's go. Saw that last clip. I don't know if I'm gonna put it in there or not, but 496 moved horrible. I don't know, I felt like really gassy and bloated. And then when I did that 496, it's like I lost all tension and I felt like my glutes not wanting to activate mid pull. So I was like, you gotta remember who the fuck you are. So, and stuck to the challenge that I had set for myself. 507 did move a little bit harder than it needed to be. I just felt like today was just one of those days where my body is just tired, you know, and that's gonna happen. So, not bad. Next week I'll just try to do 518.
Stop the cap. Stop the cap right now. Stop the cap.
And then from there we're just gonna keep on pushing. So sometimes it's more mental, and if you know you have it in you and your body is just like had a weird little miscover error, you gotta understand when to push and when to hold back. I felt like I know I had 507 today, which why I was like kinda like, there's no fucking way like I made 496 move that bad. Like that's routine, you know? So once I cleaned that up, everything felt fine, and we were able to push through and keep the form consistent, you know? So that's all you can ask for. I just watched Daryl Webster's video. He said this is the vlogging room, which low-key it is. It's so funny. It's a spider's changing room. And then me, Jamar, and Daryl, we always come in here and talk to the camera after we get done deadlifting or squatting. So my arm is extremely sore right now. But that was crazy, but I'm glad I was able to finish through. My back feels fine, everything feels good. Legs were a little bit fatigued. I think it was just from squatting yesterday. So I'm gonna send the footage over to coach, gonna do some accessory work, and then I'll catch y'all tomorrow. I know these workouts are pretty quick, but my I'm always on like a time crunch, so I'm trying to make the most out of what I have and trying to give y'all the best content possible. So catch y'all tomorrow.
Hello, motherfucker.
If you guys made it to this portion of the video, thank you. I know this has been a all over the place vlog, but I appreciate you guys' support nonetheless. Today is 16th. It is Saturday. We got heavy squats and deadlifts. You already know the plan. You already know the deal. So getting ready for the gym right now. Got on my beanie, feeling fresh. Got on that RSL right now. So yeah, it's gonna be a good day. We just been really productive this week, taking a lot of product shots and doing a lot of behind the scenes stuff for the brand and, you know, career wise. So yeah, not gonna talk too much on here. Just want to come on and give you guys a little quick update. I just appreciate
everything, and we're super excited to be launching some cool stuff in a few weeks. So yeah, next weekend should be a lot of fun. I hope you guys enjoyed the previous video. Don Rio did a great job. I loved the editing, and it was just a really dope video. So if you guys like that, go show him some love on his social media and comment, like, share, subscribe what you guys liked on that previous one. So yeah, gonna head to the gym like I just said. I'm talking all over the place again, but I'll catch y'all at the gym. We're feeling pretty good. Gonna take some pre-workout. It's gonna be a great day. Portion of the video. I appreciate y'all so much. Thank you for tuning in today's content. I think it was really good. It was just a really raw, unedited, just YouTube video with just training footage. Showcase some of the fancier edits, and I also like to do a lot of just the simple videos because it still helps me connect with you guys while adding more of my personality in there as well. So this week, in the last few weeks, have been going really good. Squat has been feeling great. Deadlifts have been feeling on point. As you guys saw, we hit a 600 pound deadlift at RP7, and we hit a 562 pounds squat single at RP7 as well, if I'm not mistaken. Everything's heading in the right direction. We are slowly but surely building that work capacity, getting stronger, getting better. A lot of technique and form refinement over these past few months from the last meet. And we're just getting ready for Raw Nationals. So it's gonna be amazing. And this following weekend, we have our amazing athletes, Nick Perry and David Perry, gonna be doing their first meet. So very excited for that too. Yeah, so if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a like, give it a comment, share, subscribe, do all that good stuff. It's your boy Dominic Rodden, AKA Mr. Rise and Shine. I'll catch y'all in the next one. Get out the way, get out the way.